So Li-Wei, it's been really fantastic to work with you again. The last time we were working together with the Orchestra of the Music Makers was at the Singapore Arts Festival.
That's right.
Where we were performing the premiere of Ho Chi Minh's Passage.
Mm-hmm.
And the Haydn is so different. It's such solid, traditional cello repertoire.
Mm-hmm.
How did you feel?
Well, first of all, you know, I feel very privileged to be invited to work with this bunch of wonderful musicians, yourself, Maestro. You know, play with Om again after, 8 years? Mm-hmm. It's a little bit like visiting an old friend. So with this orchestra, I always knew it's going to be passionate. It's going to be passionate, a bunch of wonderful musicians, enthusiasm, all that. But at the same time, you know, after these 8 years, I sense some maturity. I realized how wonderful the musicians of Om, their storytelling ability.
Mm-hmm.
You know, 8 years ago, it was their, you know, flexibility. Now, this time is how they tell this, you know, story that everybody knows, the end game, but how you tell it is very different. So it feels like, you know, growing together, growing old together.
Mm-hmm.
It's a wonderful feeling.
You know, it's really quite interesting, this business about the collaborative capacities,
mm-hmm.
not just between ourselves but also with the orchestra, because of course we are now recording and performing in rather unusual circumstances.
Mm-hmm. Often we all treat Haydn and cello concerto, both of them, like cello music.
Mm.
And one of the most important elements in playing cello music is listening.
Mm.
But with social distancing, I think that element of listening suddenly becomes a much harder task to deal with. In fact, our first rehearsal, our first performance at the Singapore Conference Hall was quite a challenging experience.
Mm.
Because you almost have to anticipate, I think not just for me,
mm.
but for yourself too.
Mm.
This time I'm going to ask you a question. As a conductor, because mm. often conductor you have to lead,
mm.
and you probably have to beat ahead
mm-hmm.
Of what the music mm. is. So this social distancing,
mm.
for you, especially the wings and mm. the players are further away than usual,
mm.
what do you do to make the adjustment?
Well, it's very challenging. There is always an elasticity
mm-hmm.
In terms of conductor and musician response.
Yeah.
And the experienced musicians understand about that elasticity.
Mm-hmm.
And over the years of working with the musicians in the orchestra, we have come to understand each other's space in elasticity.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's individually, how does one play together with a large ensemble,
mm-hmm.
but it's also about sections and how they play together within the section, and that's the challenging part. So I recall there are quite a lot of instances where there is dialogue
mm-hmm.
Between you
mm-hmm.
and different sections of the orchestra.
Mm-hmm.
So the challenge is, first of all, they have to stay together, and that's challenging for them because they're so far apart,
mm-hmm.
which means they hear each other less well.
Yes.
And then they will hear you less well as well, because you are further away
yeah.
from them
yeah.
and there aren't people in between that for them to latch on to
orally. Yeah.
Exactly. So that's one of the challenges. And the other challenge, of course, is that concert halls were designed for people making music together but being quite close to each other.
Yeah.
So now we have a lot of space. And the result of that is that there is the danger of everything coming behind and
mm.
coming later
mm.
and slower.
That's right.
So one of the things I remember doing was to remind everybody that there is a big difference between the speed of sound and the speed of light.
Yes.
And if they can see each other and be aware of each other physically, then it could, for instance, be something that they would take priority over what they hear, and that is the technique.
Remember the end of the coda of the third movement of Haydn D major.
Oh yes,
that was quite a challenging little passage.
It
because
was
exactly what you just mm-hmm. said. It's about, you know, by the time they hear me, it's late.
It's late. That's
it's
right.
Late. And then they react,
mm-hmm.
and then I hear them.
Mm-hmm.
It's double late.
Exactly.
So then all of us, so actually we had to remember, we had to do quite a big movement.
Yeah.
just so they see what's going on. And then I saw your conducting beats were a little bit ahead of what I do, which ultimately was the perfect timing. So things like that, I suppose we all learn a little bit more.
And I think this is maybe coming back to what you mentioned earlier about flexibility and about maturity. This is actually the coming together of the two.
Absolutely.
Because in the end, there is only one right timing, and that is when everyone's together.
So I think overall, I don't know about you, but I had a wonderful experience.
Oh, thank you. It's definitely mutual.
Under hand.